nice to see you all again. Now, today's class is all about spells. Unfortunately, Professor Flitwick is not with us today because, as you all know, it's the Goblin Festival and he's off to reconnect with his family. We're so happy for him. I'm sure he'll be having a marvellous time. So, back to our class. We, of course, are going to be casting some spells today. So, what is a spell? The official description is: a spell is a controlled manifestation of magic that affects the world in a supernatural fashion, such as levitating objects, conjuring fire or water, or even stunning someone. Mm-hmm. This is generally cast with an incantation which can produce jets of light. And because of this, spells usually miss, would you believe? Now, they can be dodged or they can be blocked by either producing another object or using another spell. Mm-hmm. So we are going to begin today with a very simple spell, which I'm sure most of you will be aware of. We are going to be Wingardium Leviosa. Now, who can tell me what is the purpose of this spell? Anyone? Harry? It is indeed to levitate objects. So, there are a few things that are very important to this spell. Our wand movement or motion. Do we all have our wands today? We were given specific instructions last time. Let me see. Very well done, class. That's excellent. Now, your wand movement, your incantation, your concentration, and also your intention are imperative to the success of this charm. Pretty much to all charms, if you ask me. We'll need our wand, but we will also need today an elemental orb. Yes, exactly like the one we used in charm in divination class. Well done, Hermione. So, do we all have ours? Oh, you've still to get it. Okay. Right, well, what to do is to make your elemental orb, as you'll remember, put it between your lips, expand, inflate with your magical essence until it's slightly larger than a quaffle. That's it. Give it a good blow. That's it. Once it's at the correct size, we tie off our elemental orb to contain our magical essence inside. Are we all ready? Well done. Right, put this to the side for just a moment and we are going to practice our incantation. So pay attention, class, this is very important. Wingardium Leviosa. Repeat after me. Wingardium Leviosa. One more time, class. Wingardium Leviosa. Well done. Now the next thing we have to practice is our wand movement. So we begin at the left. My right, I think it's up here to you. A little bit of a curve and a swish down. Okay, let's try again, class. Flick. Flick. Well done, we're doing not too badly. Let's try one more time and then we'll put it all together. Are you ready, class? And flick. Well done. Now, get your elemental orb, ready. We're going to say our incantation and make it of levity. Are you ready? Wingardium Leviosa! Well done! Let me see, class. Very good. Very good. That was excellent. Now, as with all magic, you'll need a wee bit of practice. So keep on practicing. You should all, of course, have your spell book. And inside you will find your list of wand motions. And I want you for next time to practice all these different charms, and we'll see how well you have done. Now, with all charms, there can be a wee bit of an exception. And with this charm, does anyone know what the exception is? No? Well, this charm does not work on humans. You cannot make them float into space, unfortunately. If you ever see someone levitating, it is simply the charm working upon the clothing, not on their actual being. So perhaps you'll have to think of another charm or spell if you've got someone you want to send into space. Well, very well done, everyone. And your next class is going to be Care of Magical Creatures. So I want you to do a wee bit of studying, a wee bit of learning about all those creatures. Well done, class. Class, dismissed. Off you go now.